Hi guys, Squirrel here, and I'm back with some BeamNG. I think you guys liked the last video I did, and you've been asking for some more, so with this one, I've got the Logitech G27 steering wheel to work with BeamNG. I'm going to leave a link in the description with details of what to do. It's quite simple. I've got a file in my Dropbox folder. You just drop it into the right place in BeamNG. Again, details in the description. And off you go. It'll just pick up the steering wheel. I believe it works with G27 and G25. So I'm going to show you what it's like and how to use it. It's not a full implementation, but it's good enough. Let's just get over onto this grid map, because that's always a good laugh, isn't it? Right. Okay, the first thing to know is this. Having got the G27 set up here, you can't see it, obviously. If I press the brake, foot pedal, you'll notice it goes backwards. If I press accelerate, it goes forward. Okay, that is one way of doing this. If we press C to go in the car, you'll see what happens. As I press brake, you see on the dashboard down there, just below the speedometer, as I press down the accelerate, you'll see it automatically goes into drive. As I hold the brake down, it then moves back into neutral. That's the default way of doing things. There is an alternative way, and it's like this. If I press the Q key, like that, when I press the brake now, you'll see I'm holding brake and all it does is stay in neutral, which is what you would expect it to do. You then have a couple of options, okay? You know you've got the paddles just behind the steering wheel. If you press the right paddle, you'll notice it goes into drive, and then you can hold the accelerator key down. Notice it doesn't change gear, so it's not fully automatic. It's kind of a hybrid. It's basically a paddle shift now, so let's go this way actually. If I press the paddle key again, do you hear it change? So now we're paddle shifting and then down into neutral. Now if you want to go to reverse, you do the left paddle, that'll put you into reverse. You can now accelerate and brake, right paddle back into neutral. So that basically puts it into a paddle shift mode. That was by pressing the Q key. Now, it doesn't just end there. That's the other cool thing. If you don't want to use paddles, if you've got the H shifter as well, that now works. So if you put this straight into first gear on the H shifter, off we go. As I accelerate forward, I can stick it into second, and then third, and then fourth, and so on. And brake. So basically, you've got a choice. You can use the paddle shift, or you can use the stick, the H shifter, and put it into whatever gear you want, which is kind of cool. The steering is pretty heavy. I don't know if that's a final implementation, but turning the steering with the force feedback is pretty heavy going. Or the one last thing I should mention, if you put it in your stick into neutral, press P and you'll put the parking brake on. That can be quite handy when you want to just, when you're on a hill. And as I am now, you just want to stop the truck from rolling back. So if I press P and turn that off, let's go up this hill, you see what I mean. So I put it into neutral, I'm just going to hold the foot brake down, and if I press P, put the parking brake on. As you can see, I've got the parking brake on, and because the hill is so steep, I'm still kind of rolling down that steep bit, but it's good enough to hold it there. The physics is a bit weird, as you can see, it's kind of meandering backwards and forwards. I don't know, obviously it's just an alpha implementation, but the physics gets a bit strange with the parking brake on. If I turn it off, you see it rolls and I hold the foot brake down, and you can see it kind of wobbling around as the different forces are kind of balancing each other out. But the main thing is, you can see now, I've got a steering wheel, I'm turning it left, and I can turn it right like that. And you've got the full analog control, which is just what you need for a game like this. So we don't need to stop there. We don't need to use the keyboard anymore. We can actually have some fun. So let's go and have some fun. Let's go and hit one of these ramps up. Where's that big ramp? I quite like, there's a big, there it is in the distance, you see it? Let's see if we can go and hit that. I always like hitting this ramp, because it absolutely destroys the car. There we go. Holy shit! Boom! Look at that. That never gets dull. Just look at the pieces that have flown off. Now here's the really interesting bit. Let's press Control R. Let's reset that. Okay, so where are we? We are... Oh, there's the... Let's go pick up some speed and do that again. Oh, they inverted the mouse as well. This is 0.303 developer release. So if you bought it, you can just go to your normal download link, and you can see you can download the release version they released at the tech demo release, or you can release this latest. You can pull down this latest developer release, which I'll show you some of the weird dev features you've got in a second. Let's spin around and do that again. There we go. Okay, now before we do this, now I want to show you some of this weird stuff. If you press Control, is it Control F1? No, not Control F1. It's just Shift F1. There we go. Now, look at this. Basically, what you can do now is you can press J and K. We'll cycle through the different debug consoles that you've got going. So you can see top left, you've got all kind of graphics things, 80 frames per second. If I press K, then I'm now in terrain debug, which, you know, obviously this means something to developers. No idea what it means to me. Press K again. This one is in input debug. So you can see if I press the accelerator or the brake, it's showing you the different bars that are coming in from the input devices, which is kind of cool. It's funny to see all this stuff. You never normally see any of this. But look at this one. This has got the throttle and the stick there. You can see the gear as I go through the different gears and the brakes. I can even put it into reverse with the proper H-shift reverse. It's got that enabled. There we go. Parking brake on. You get that. It's all the inputs and stuff. It's even got the fuel levels and the water temperature. And then you've got collision triangles. So these are obviously the vertices that it's looking out for when it's going to hit something. And when you press K again, you then get more collision triangles. You get node weights. Look inside. Look at this. This is crazy. Look at that. The weights on the individual nodes. 0.2 kilograms. 0.5. Watch what happens if I get into the... What's the side of the car? That one. No, not that one. That one. There you go. Look at this as I start to move forward. You see all the different... There's basically triangles going on here, all the different vertices, and they've got what weight is being applied to them. It's just insane. It's like, it's just a little bit, reminds me of getting inside the Matrix. It almost feels like you've jumped inside the Matrix, and you can see math, basically maths being, which is what this is. I mean, all games are like this. They're just essentially maths, lots and lots of real-time calculations, but it's just completely nuts to be able to see it in action. Collision triangle debug. So what we'll do is we'll go up that ramp again and we'll leave these triangles on. You'll see what happens. Pick up some speed in our little pickup truck. We can of course use a different vehicle. We'll do that in a sec. Let's try not to miss the ramp. Ooh! Look at it. Watch this. Boom! Pieces have fallen off. Triangles have been deformed. That's what it looks like to the computer inside. To us, it just looks like if I press Alt F1, gets rid of it all. That's what we see. But inside, it's doing a lot of complicated mathematics. I've obviously smashed the engine. I don't know what this is. A piece is still attached, I think. Can I drive this thing? Presumably, that's going to snap off in a sec. No, it's actually going to keep hold of that, apparently. That's incredible. Why would it even do that? So, anyway, Control R will reset the vehicle. And Control E, we can choose a different one, so let's do that. Let's go for the Chevetta Blood. This is... Do you remember this sports car from the first video I did, the first BeamNG? I actually don't think that this thing's implemented properly. There's something really, really unstable. And I thought it was just the fact I was using the keyboard, but having played with this car, if I accelerate, You see how it steps out of line? I mean, fair enough, this is a rear-wheel drive. It's quite a powerful engine. But I'll take it on the test track in a minute. You'll see what I mean. It's just... It's just impossible to keep going in a straight line with this thing. The power it puts down... just when you make a turn, look. Even the most basic things. What it feels to me is... It feels like the tyres do not have anywhere near enough friction. But a car like this would have quite a lot of grip on the tyres, and it seems when you go around the corners, you put your power down and it just gets out of shape. Like, uncontrollably out of shape. Like, a bit like this. It feels like you're riding around on marshmallows instead of tyres. That's the only way you can describe it. So I mean, it's just... I don't actually like this car to drive in this game at the moment, because it is so crazy. Just got through some debug. There we go. I'm trying to back off the accelerator just so that I can put it in a straight line. Let's see if I can get up here. Oh my god. Oh! I landed on a hill. I tell you what. I'd be dead at that point, wouldn't I? No, absolutely no roll cage whatsoever. Look at it, I just squished it. It looks a little pancake now. Let's reset that. Yeah, I actually prefer some of the other vehicles, to be honest. The Gavril. This is a bit mad. And when you press Control E and you bring up the Gavril, you can do different options. So you can go for a stripped-down version of it like this. And these are actually quite fun. This thing doesn't behave in like a really crazy way, like the Bullard or whatever it's called. This is just a lot of fun. I love watching the exhaust rattle around this one. But you can see even this, friction-wise on the tyres, even this just feels a bit wrong. Let's get some speed. Come on. Do you get the idea of like these ramps? Bosh! There you go, that's now 2D as well. Very, very flat. So you can do a boxed version, you could do the normal version, or you can do this, which is basically what we call, in the UK, we call these a Luton van. Similar kind of shape as a Luton van, although Luton van's a little bit higher than that, but it's about the closest thing you'll get to a Luton van. Don't ask me why we call it that. I'm not really sure. This is pretty much the biggest thing you can hire in the UK on a standard driver's license. So you kind of use it when you're... If you're moving home on the cheap, you would hire one of these and do about 3 or 4 runs with it. I know this because I've done it. Let's get inside. There we go. No track hire at the moment, unfortunately, which is fair enough. Just trying to hit this ramp at an angle. Oh! And of course the box gets smashed to bits. Oh, I can't ride it now. I don't think I can get it out of this situation. That's a shame. Control E, and we'll have a Gavril Grand Marshal Sport. There we go. The sports version. Now this isn't a bad drive. Again, it's got a lot of power for those little marshmallow white tyres. Very, very easy to get it out of shape. But it feels like a luxury 5 Series BMW or something. Let's see if I can get it in there. I don't like these tubes very much. They're very hard to navigate around. Oh, shit. That didn't work out too good. Yeah, made a mess of that. Right, so let's go down for a different track. If we hit play and let's go around on this one, right? This is the test track. I'll show you what I mean about that. That Goleeder being impossible to control. Where are you? Sorry, Goleeder? Belida. Civetta Belida. Right, I'm going to go first person on this. I've driven quite a lot of racing games in my time, and I've never seen anything as unstable as this, which makes me think the physics is wrong. So I've got control at the moment because I'm not accelerating that much. Watch what happens even in the most basic of bends. Try and put my foot down a little bit. There we go. Oh, it's out of shape. It's completely impossible to get under control again. Back to first gear. You want to put your power down in a straight line. But watch this bend. I'm going to hit the brakes. Turning. It's not... doesn't feel like it's gripping at all. I'm pretty certain in real life I could take this around these bends a little bit better than this. One of the worst bends is this one. It's deceiving, this bend. If you hit the brakes now, accelerate round. That took a while to get anywhere near that level of skill. This one here, I'm struggling with the wood steering. This one here, you almost always end up in the ditch down the side. You've got to be so careful with that bend. But, you know, it is just... it's so unstable, it's not fun enough. There are better ones. One of my favourite cars, actually, in this game is this one, which is essentially looks like a Honda Civic, doesn't it? Actually, it's called a Comet. Let's go for, should we go for the rally version or the sport version? Let's go sport. Okay, so we've got the sporty version as opposed to the off-road rally version, which I'm guessing just tightens up the physics a little bit. Let's try that. When you do exit back to the main menu and come back in again, you do have to press Q. Have I gone the right way? Don't think I've gone the right way. You have to press Q to re-enable that manual shift again. It kind of forgets it. It's not a static option in the game yet, so... and it's very early days, don't forget this. This game is only just beyond the tech demo, really. I think they got something like 60,000 funding in the end, and they wanted 40. Which, I think when they hit the 50,000 mark, they were going to add a multiplayer version. So obviously they've hit that target, which is cool, because it essentially means we're going to have a multiplayer version of this game. Which is going to be fun. But you can see already, this is... it's more fun, because you can just kind of control it. It doesn't want to go out of line all the bloody time. The tyres feel like they can cope a bit better with the power and the chassis. It doesn't bounce around, it doesn't feel so soft. The steering doesn't feel right yet. I think that's a ratio thing. I mean, this is not an official G25, G27 support, which again is something they're going to put in the game based on the kickstart they got. It went past that level of support, so they will put an official G25, G27 steering wheel in, which is going to be awesome. But right now, it kind of feels like, well, I think it is essentially a steering wheel being mapped to a game controller. So it's all right at first when you're steering, but once you get about, I say, half a turn round, it no longer feels like the steering ratio is working quite as it should. But it's definitely better than the keyboard mouse, which was what I used last time. It's a massive step up from that. So if you have got a wheel, G25 or G27, you can definitely use the link that I've given you. If you've got another kind of steering wheel, then I suggest that you go on the forum, on the BeamNG forum, and have a look. And if you can't see an answer to your question for your wheel, then post one. Because some of the guys can definitely advise you on that. And you can actually make your own custom input maps if you want, if you know a little bit about what you're doing. It's not rocket science, but you should be able to do it if you can't find one. If not, somebody might do one for you, you never know. Stop that. And okay, so let's go around that one of my favorite tracks in this game, or maps I should be called, is this one, which is Small Island. That one and that one, Dry Rock Island, these are my two favorites. Then we're going to go with the Grand Marshal Police Package. And then we're going to have fun. Turn the brake off. There we go. Oh, right. So when you choose a new car, it doesn't start with the brake on, even though you had it turned on. That's good to know. Thanks, game. Oh. So this game is... I don't think they've got a release schedule yet. I don't think they've got a particular plan. Should we go outside? There we go. Don't think they've got a particular plan for it, in terms of deliverables and release dates and stuff. But it's, I'm definitely going to keep my eye on it, and I'm going to try and get hold of the developers and see if they'll talk to me, see if I can help promote this game a little bit. Because I just love the physics. The actual deformation physics in this game are absolutely epic and great fun. Which is why I'm taking another look at it with the steering wheel, and I've took my doors off. Should we go down the beach? But it is a little bit limited. It's only a tech demo. It is a little bit kind of... Actually, I like driving with no doors on. It's kind of cool. Firstly, you could just pull up on the beach and hop out and grab yourself pina colada. Oh, I think I'm going to go in the water if I'm not careful. Bugger. Get up, get up, get up. This is, like I say, 0.303 or something, and they did fix a lot of stuff in it since the original tech release. So if you did buy this game, then absolutely go and get the updated version. When you start it, it should just update itself. I was actually looking for an updater program, but it just seems to come with it. This is quite cool driving down the beach, actually. It's good scenery as well. The graphics are... Oh, shit. I don't think I'm getting out of this one. Nope. In the latest release, they made it kill the engine when you go into water. So again, you're stuck with the problem now. How do you get out? See, if you press F1, it says, if you press Control E parts config, Control I resets a vehicle, Control R to reload in place, but there's no reload back at spawn, which is what it needs. Control R will just load you where you are, and Control and I will just reset your vehicle. So you're kind of screwed. You have to come back out, which is... Yeah, like I say, it's only an alpha, so we'll forgive them, but... A little thing, I don't think it'd be too hard to put in. Now this is one of my other favourites, the Dry Rock Island. We'll have one final look at this before we end the video. But I hope you enjoyed BMNG. I think it's quite a cool game. I'd love to see some of this physics actually brought into Euro Truck. I think maybe press Q. I think SCS should get hold of the guys who make this and let's go for the rally front wheel drive. Well, let's try the front wheel drive. Sounds fun. I think SCS should get hold of the developers and see if they can license their physics engine and bring it into one of the trucking games. Because it would just be insane to have this kind of physics in a trucking game. Oh, front wheel drive. I so much prefer front wheel to rear. As you can see, it's just a lot easier to control with a steering wheel and pedals. Oh, he says going straight into a bunch of trees, which, to be fair, it wouldn't have mattered if I had a wheel or not. I'd have screwed up then, because I wasn't paying much attention. Now, it looks like we're going forward. Okay. I couldn't reverse because it was spawning me in front of a tree all the time. Let's stick on that rally package. Oh yeah. This reminds me of something like you know the island in Far Cry 3? Kinda reminds me of that. I think we're jammed on that. I think I broke my engine again. It's the other thing, with all this wonderful deformation physics going on, it's a little bit too easy to trash your vehicle. Can you imagine a multiplayer of this? Like, the sheer amount of collisions. Other players just driving into other players all the time. I don't think you'd end up with a full race. I don't think... I think the winner would just be the person who managed to stay out of trouble. I don't think anybody would finish a lap, to be honest. It'd be carnage. Absolute carnage. I mean, it's difficult enough as it is. But like I say, the steering is a bit weird. Let's get some speed around these roads. Try not to go into some trees this time. I definitely prefer first person in driving games. I like feeling like I'm in the cockpit. I don't like kind of third person. It does look better in terms of seeing stuff in the video. I managed to not crash over that bridge. I'm impressed. Oh, where's that sharp bend? Oh my god. A T-junction. I thought it was meant to be a rally track. I just noticed the rev counter, actually. I'm actually sticking it in the red an awful lot. A bit too much, actually. See the rev counter down there? It goes up to like 6,500 before it gets into the red. So I should be changing about there, actually. Oh, I've shattered the windscreen. I think I've killed the engine. I have killed the engine. Again, all this physics. I do love it though. I love this debug stuff as well. Just being able to see all the component pieces of the model. It's just brilliant. And completely crazy. Look at the wheels spinning around though. Look at the mats. This is the only way to play a game in debug mode. All games should have this shit turned on. You should be able to just turn it on just for amusement. I mean, it wouldn't hurt the developer, would it? It'd just be cool to see it. Racing around a track, looking at the numbers. This is showing base materials. That's okay. There you go. It's all the loads now. All the different weights. Oh, just about made it. So I don't know. What do you think? What do you think about BeamNG? They can't really do... I can't really do many... kind of videos with it right now, beyond what I've already shown you, because this is it. This is the limit of the game. Wow, the frame rate seems to have dropped. Oh, look at this! Underneath, you can go underneath the surface and look at all the mathematics. That's so cool. So what I'll have to do is I'll have to wait until the... I have to keep my eye on the releases, I think. And when they do a release with something really interesting in, then we'll make another video and take a look at it. So that's the only way I can do it. But they don't have a release schedule, so I don't really know when that's going to be or what's going to come out next. But I'll keep my eye on it. But for now, I just wanted to make another video just to show you the game working properly, if you like, with a steering wheel. Because it is kind of cool. If you haven't bought it already, then I suggest you do. Can't Kickstarter anymore, but I think you can still buy it and support the indie. It's such a cool game. Anyway, I think that is going to be the end of the video. So, let's just turn all that crap off. There we go. Back to my lovely shiny car. Cool. There's no horn for me to toot at you, so I can't do that. But I hope you enjoyed the video. Until the next BeamNG, whenever that's going to be, leave me your comments. Let me know what you think of this game. And anyway, take care, guys. See you soon.